If you want to be able to create custom audiences, have different team members manage different parts of your social media presence, or manage other people's ad accounts and assets, then you need to set up a business manager. We're going to address all of that and more in today's video. All right, here we go. To find out if you already have a business manager or a business suite, go to business.facebook.com. And if you do already have a business manager and you want another one, or you want to start from scratch, go to business.facebook.com/create, and that will prompt you to create a new account. If you're already logged in, then you're gonna see a page that looks like this. But if you're not logged in yet, you're going to get a prompt to go ahead and log into your personal Facebook profile. This is a great time to remind you as well that Facebook does not want you creating a fake personal profile just to run your ads. You always want to connect your ads managers, your business suite to your actual personal Facebook profile. In other words, the profile that you're using to connect with family and friends. The first thing that you're going to do is click on the button that says create account. The little dialog box will pop up asking for your business name and your name and your email. Go ahead and fill that out and then click submit. You're going to see a screen that looks like this. Just as a reminder, Business Manager is like your hub. So this is where you're putting all of your people, your Instagram accounts, your Facebook pages, your ad accounts, your pixels. And then this is also where you can determine who's in charge of what and what they're able to do on each of these assets. We're gonna start with accounts. Even though people appear first in your Business Manager, it's a little bit easier to assign access once you've added all of your assets into your account. When you click on pages, there's going to be a little blue box that says add. Let's go ahead and click that. You have three options that are going to pop up. Click on add a page to bring in all of your existing pages that your business already owns. Remember, the goal is to bring in all of your assets to your business manager so that you can disperse permission to your employees, your partners, your contractors, etc. The next option is to request access to a page. So this is going to be if you need to perform work on behalf of somebody else's company on their page or their Instagram account, et cetera, you're going to request access to those assets. So you do not own them. And the third thing you can do is create a new page. So if you want to create a brand new Facebook page, you can do that here as well. Let's go ahead and add a page. You'll type in your page name or URL and then simply click add page and it will bring it into your business manager. The next thing that you want to pull into your business manager are your ad accounts. Again, you have three options when you click the add button up at the top. The first option is to add an existing ad account that you own. The second option is to request access to an ad account that you need to manage. And the third option is to create a new ad account. Once you click add a new ad account, you're going to need to put your ad account ID right in here, and then you will be able to add this to your business manager. When you add an ad account to your business manager, it is permanent. If you request access to an ad account, that is not permanent, and you can always remove that out of your business manager. When you create your personal profile, you automatically get an ad account attached to your name. Instead of creating a new ad account and creating confusion down the road, you can go ahead and pull in your existing ad account to your business manager. Now, if I'm guessing correctly, you may already have a couple of ad accounts and it could be confusing. At the very end, I'm gonna show you how to sort all of this out. The next thing on the menu is business asset groups. If you want to create asset groups of your pages and your pixels and your Instagram accounts and all of that, you can do that right here. Simply click create business asset group. There's going to be four options that pop up, and this will give you a really good idea of how this could be useful for your business. Perhaps you have separate brands or lines of business, or maybe you operate in different regions, or if you have an agency and you manage a lot of client assets, all of these would be great scenarios for which you would want to create these business asset groups. So for example, if I'm an agency and I want to create all all of client A's assets and client B's assets into little bundles. And then I can just give my team members access to all of client A's bundle or all of client B's bundle. It just creates an organizational structure that's a little bit easier to manage. Next, we're into apps. So if you have any apps that you need to connect into Facebook, you're going to do that right here. The next thing that you'll want to do is connect any Instagram accounts. So go ahead and click Instagram accounts, click add. And from here, it's going to pop up with a little dialog box to actually connect your Instagram account. So you'll need to log in and do a little verification, and then it will pull your account into your business manager. If you've created any lines of business inside of Facebook, you can go ahead and add those here. Next, you can add any WhatsApp accounts that you want to connect to your business manager. And now we're down to our data sources. So if you have any catalog set up, perhaps for your e-commerce store with all of your SKUs, this is where you're going to start the process of adding that catalog right in here. The next section is the pixel section. So if you want to create any new pixels, you will create those here and then give permissions here as well. Remember that you only need one pixel per business. If you want more information on how to properly set up and use the pixel, watch our video that we have linked right here. If you have any offline events created, you can go ahead and add those into your business manager right here. You can also add your custom conversions right here into business manager. You'll just simply click add and it will allow you to add a custom conversion in or to create a new custom conversion right here in Business Manager. Any shared audiences that you have with another ad account will live right here under the shared audiences section. Just remember that when you're sharing audiences, you can get into some privacy territory. So typically only ad accounts that are owned by the same business would share audiences. And finally for this section, if you have any creative folders, you're gonna add those in right under the business creative folders. The next section is the payment methods. You can add one payment method in right here, and you can use this payment method and associate it with different ad accounts. When you want to run ads on Facebook, you're going to need to make sure that you have a payment method associated with your account. So if you are feeling like, I don't have all of that stuff, most people just start with their business manager with an ad account, Instagram account, a Facebook page, a pixel, and that's it. So if that's all you have, pull those pieces into your business manager, and that's perfect. Before we move on to the next step, if you are getting value from today's video, please give this a like and subscribe to our channel. Let's go ahead and move on to the step of adding your team members, contractors, and partners into your business manager and assigning them to each of these assets. The first thing that you're going to do is add your people. So go ahead and click the add button and fill out the dialog box that pops up. You're going to enter their email and also determine if they have admin access to your business manager or employee access. Just a word of caution, don't let everybody in your business have admin access. This should really only be for people who have responsibility over all of your assets, including your payment methods. So keep those admins to a minimum. Facebook does say that it is best practice to make sure that you have two admins or more on each business manager. That way, if you suddenly get locked out of your Facebook for some reason, at least somebody else can go ahead and make sure that everything continues to move forward without you. Once you click next, that's where you're going to determine which assets each person has access to. Just a reminder that admins have access to your entire business manager. They can add themselves or remove themselves from any assets that you have in your business manager. Employees only have access to the specific assets that you assign them. For both admins and employees, you still need to assign all of the assets to them. So let's go through this piece by piece. You're going to click on pages and then select the page that you want to give access to. Read through the menu options carefully and select between partial access, task access, Facebook access, or full control. Remember that when you add somebody in, you can always remove them later or update their permissions. The next thing that you're going to give access to is your ad account. So go ahead and click on the ad account and then you will see a menu of options. Perhaps you have somebody who's just evaluating performance and they don't need to manage campaigns, or you might have somebody who's is working on creating mockups for you inside of Creative Hub. If you have somebody that is going to be running ads for you, you want to allow them to manage campaigns and or manage ad account. The next thing you're going to give permission to is any catalogs that you have set up in your business. Same for apps. If you have created any new pixels for your account, you're also going to give access here. You'll select the pixel, and then you're going to go ahead and select either partial access or full control. And finally, this is where you're going to give access to Instagram. So go ahead and select the Instagram account that you want this person to have access to, and then read through the menu of options and determine which level of control you would like them to have. Once you've given this person all of the access you want them to have, go ahead and click invite. That invitation also goes to their email. They can go ahead and click the link, verify, and then they will have access to your business manager assets that you have allocated to them. Once you've added your people to your account, now you can add in any other partners that you need to. Go ahead and click add, and you'll see two options pop up. One is to give a partner access to your assets, and another is to request access to another partner's account. If you want more detail on how business managers interact with each other, how to connect them so that you can run other people's ad accounts or manage other assets in their business manager, we've got an amazing video on that. We're going to link it in the description box below. Now, what if you want to remove a team member or even an asset from your business manager? Simply go to the category. So let's say it's a business page. Click on the business page, then click on the team member who is assigned to this asset. Click the little pull down menu right here by their name and simply click remove from page. This will remove their access to that page. Likewise, if you have any asset that you want to remove from your business manager, simply click on the categories such as pages, Instagram accounts, etc., and then you will see a button on the top right that says remove. So any account that you've requested access to, you can simply remove out of your account when you need to. Speaking of removing accounts, if you are like most people that we encounter, there is a spider web of accounts on the back end of your Facebook business managers and ad accounts and business suites and all of the tools that Facebook has for us. 90% of people that I talk to have multiple ad accounts, multiple business managers, and they are so confused about what goes to what. So let me show you a way that you can organize this. Now, if you want, you can try to clean up some of this as well. You can close certain types of ad accounts or remove certain types of assets, and that will help clean things up as well. But for a lot of accounts, once they're created, you're kind of locked into them. A great way to organize this and kind of keep everything straight is simply to rename these accounts so you know which ones are active and which ones are backups. Before I show you how to rename these accounts, let's just see how many you actually have. On the top left-hand corner of your screen, if you click this little pull down, you're going to see how many business managers you have created or have access to. So you can simply click on these business managers, scroll down to where you see business info on the left-hand side, then you can edit the name of this business manager. So if you have multiple business managers, you might just name this your business name active, something like that, just to indicate that this is the business manager you are going to use. And then you can go to any business managers that you're not using. You can call those backup accounts or inactive accounts and just go ahead and rename them so that you're keeping track of which ones are active, which ones should you be using, and which ones are you going to save for later. Now, we can do the same thing with our ads accounts. Unbeknownst to most people, they usually have a couple of ads accounts created just because Facebook gets a little bit confusing behind the scenes. So go ahead and click on your ad accounts, click on the ad account that you've pulled into your business manager, click on open in ads manager. That will open the ad account in a new tab, and you can see, is that an ad account that you're actively using, or do you want to keep this ad account as a backup? And just to show you how many ad accounts you may have created, click on the little pull down menu and see more ad accounts. Again, you can rename these to make it really, really clear which ones you're using right now and which ones you're going to reserve as backup accounts, or just label them as inactive accounts. For more information about Business Suite, Business Manager, how to connect business managers, etc., check out this playlist. I know you're going to love it.